Ecclesiastes, chapter 3, verses 1 through 8. There's a season for everything, time for every occupation under heaven. Time for giving birth, a time for dying. Time for planting, time for uprooting what has been planted. Time for killing, time for healing. A time for knocking down and a time for building. A time for tears, a time for laughter. A time for mourning, a time for dancing. A time for keeping silent, a time for speaking. A time for loving, a time for hating, and a time for war. What really goes through the mind of a child when he's playing with his toy soldiers? Is it really only a game? Or does the effect last through adulthood? When he sets his toy soldiers upon the battlegrounds in all their battle array, is he in actuality already preparing for some battle in life? He sets a soldier in rows, he has his tanks, his armored weapons carriers. What really are the causes of war? Any war? Do these causes have to be earth-shaking? What really goes through the minds of these children? Are the causes something important, or can they sometimes be very trivial? Some object such as a chicken.
What do you want with a stupid chicken?
I want that chicken.
I'm going to kill your chicken.
You let that chicken there, I'm going to protect him with my army.
I'm going to take him over to my side.
You better let that chicken there.
I'm going to take him.
You better not.
I'll bet you 3 lollipops, 2 baseball cards, 2 hockey sticks, and a dead snail that you won't get that chicken.
You're on.
You'll bring my chicken back here.
I'm taking him over to my
side.
Bring
him back here. If you don't bring him back here, I'm
going to
do something.
You're big boy.
Take that. Take that, too.
You're gonna get it. We'll show you.
Hey,
there you go.
That.
Here's your right.
I'm gonna tell my daddy.
All the men are assembled, Colonel Sanders.
Oh, it is.
What's going on
here? Okay, men. Get in line.
Oh, come on.
Stomachs in, chest out. Now, this here is a serious undertaking. D-Day has gone down in history. This is to be known as C-Day. Now, here we have the map. We go up this line down here. You will hit the sentry. Stab him. That's right. It'll be tough for one of you men to undertake this. You have to study this map. I'll go over it with you. Now, I'm going to ask for one volunteer. Just one of you fine fellows. Just one. Please step forward. Okay, now shoot right over there. See how you target practice
is. Fall apart.
Very good, you missed it. Okay, now we have a little push-up exercise. Let's go. Up, 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 up. Fine. Okay, now you were attacking with this.
Give me a stupid sticker. I can't defend myself with this.
It's better than nothing.
Come on, Colonel.
Okay, now you sneak up on the sentry.
Yeah, but the stick's too
hit him over the head with the stick. Almost. It's better than
he
last time.
He was gonna dock.
Okay, now we have a little maneuvering exercise here. You're to run where I tell you. Okay,
I can't
go over there.
Boots on.
That has no difference. Go over there. Okay, now back. A little farther. Okay. You'll not get far this way, Private.
Back.
This is a lot of work.
Last time I saw you. Okay, now here's the chicken. The prime objective.
Some chicken.
Get the chicken. You have to stand on your feet, Private, to get the chicken.
I'll get him this time. Don't worry about it.
Shall I ask for another
bye-bye. Why did I go and volunteer? What a stupid life. Here I am crawling out in the middle of some dumb cornfield and Colonel Sanders is back there in his nice cozy tent. I asked him what to use for a weapon. He says, pick up a corn stalk. They don't shoot chickens, do they? Geez, they could at least cut a fence for me. Probably get stuck going over it. I'll tell you, this is mighty hard on the clothes. Let alone the skin. It has some importance to the colonel. Maybe it's a moral war. Probably just to prove something to the enemy. Anyway, I'll get this sentry. Hope he don't hate me for it. It's kind of stupid looking, though. I guess he deserves everything he gets. Goodbye, old comrade. Get his watch now. Wentworth's got some money on him. Maybe he's a rich beggar. Hey, this Timex is still running. Looks like that's about it. Whoops, my club. Off again. Now through all this manure, they could at least clean up the barnyard. Horses, plenty of horses. We could steal them instead of a chicken. It must be 50 times the size. I'll have to catch one on my way out. Make it a lot faster. Another fence. They could at least get these fences out of the way. And a roof yet. Probably fall off and bust something. Steep one at that. This chicken better be mighty important, boy. I tell you, this is getting to be awful hard. Especially with a corn stalk. You could at least give me a gun or something. It's windy out here. Now be careful now. Getting close. There he is. I hope this darn hazel don't duck like the last one. Poor guy. I hope I don't get shot for switching uniforms if they catch me. Boy, this guy's stiff already. Look at him. Hope he's worth more than what the last one was. And his watch is still running, too. What is it with these guys? They're all pretty ritzy. Now for the chicken house. Got him. Boy, this guy's going to make a good eating. So much for their supply hut. Oh, man, I'm the new cook.
Oh, howdy.
Guess I know what I have for supper tonight.
Yep, chicken. It's all easy going now. One last fence. All these fences, geez, you think they could cut the fences for me.
What's this?
Hey, what happened to hell?
They stole the chicken.
Hey,
they got our chicken.
Look, there's a trap.
The trap.
He went that way. Let's follow him.
We gotta get that chicken back.
Yeah. Let's get our chicken.
Where'd he go?
Down there. It went down there. We're gonna get our army, boy. You're gonna be sorry. We'll get our army and get it back.
That general must be crazy. What are you doing going down the hill here?
Where are we anyway?
Well, I can't swim. Where are the jungles of Asia? Where are we?
We gotta get that chicken back.
Hey, don't go that way, man. It's poison ivy.
Hey, Jaskowski, did you put on your deodorant this morning?
Nah, Jamlinski. I got 24-hour protection. I'm safe.
That's correct. Yeah, hey,
come on, man.
Poison ivy.
Keep going up the hill.
Is that what that rash is?
Keep your heads down.
Keep down low.
Get up here.
Hey, this reminds me of maneuvers of college.
Get out the beach.
Colonel! Holy Colonel! Hey, look out! They're here! Look out! They're right over there! They're over by the creek! Get out of my way! Hey, Colonel! Colonel! Colonel, they're over there!
What? What's this? What? What? Where? Who? Why? When? Hey, they're over there! They're over there! Hey! Hey! Don't leave! Don't leave! Let's go! Come on! In line! Let's go! Hey! Let's go! Let's go! In line! Hey! You over there! Down! Shh! Be quiet! Shut up! No! See them over there? I don't either, but they're over there. Okay? No? They're gonna be coming up on us.
All right. Ready? There they are. Oh, watch that. Okay. There they are. You see them.
All right. Okay. There's the enemy over there.
Again!
Hello, Colonel. Right, line up. Get going. Okay, I have four count. Charge! Get him! Charge! Come on!
Doesn't it?
Chapter 3, verses 1 through 8. There's a season for everything, time for every occupation under heaven. A time for giving birth, a time for dying. A time for planting, a time for uprooting what has been planted. A time for killing, a time for healing. A time for knocking down and a time for building. A time for tears, a time for laughter. A time for mourning, a time for dancing. A time for keeping silent, a time for speaking. A time for loving, a time for hating, and a time for war. Through the mind of a child when he's playing with his toy soldiers? Is it really only a game? Or does the effect last through adulthood? When he sets his toy soldiers upon the battlegrounds in all their battle array, is he in actuality already preparing for some battle in life? He sets a soldier in rows. He has his tanks, his armored weapons carriers. What really are the causes of war? Any war? Do these causes have to be earth-shaking? What really goes through the minds of these children? Are the causes something important, or can they sometimes be very trivial? Some object such as a chicken.
What do you want with a stupid chicken?
I want that chicken.
I'm
going
to kill your chicken.
You let that chicken there, I'm going to protect him with my army.
I'm going to take him over to my side.
You better let that chicken there.
I'm going to take him.
You better not.
I'll bet you 3 lollipops, 2 baseball cards, 2 hockey sticks, and a dead snail that you won't get that chicken.
You're on.
You'll bring my chicken back here.
I'm taking him over to my
side. Bring him back here. If you don't bring him back here, I'm
going to
do something.
You big boy.
Take that. Take that!
You're gonna get! We'll
show you! Hey,
there you go!
Lap.
Here's your right!
I'm gonna tell my daddy!
All the men are assembled, Colonel Sanders.
Oh, yeah. What's going on
here? Okay, men. Get in line.
Oh, come on.
Stomachs in, chest out. Well, this here is a serious undertaking. D-Day has gone down in history. This is to be known as C-Day. Now, here we have the map. We go up this line down here. You will hit the sentry, stab him. That's right. It'll be tough for one of you men to undertake this. You have to study this map. I'll go over it with you. Now, I'm going to ask for one volunteer. Just one of you fine fellows. Just one. Please step forward. Okay, now shoot right over there. See how you start to practice
this. Fall apart.
Very good, you missed it. Okay, now we have a little push-up exercise. Let's go. Up. Fine. Okay, now you were attacking me with this.
Give me a stupid stick. I can't defend myself with this.
It's better than nothing.
Come on, Colonel.
Okay, now you just sneak up on the sentry.
Hit
him over the head with the stick. Almost. It's better than last time.
He was going to duck.
Okay, now we're going to have a little maneuvering exercise here. You're going to run right to you. Okay, go over there. That has no difference. Go over there. Okay, now back. A little more farther. Okay. You'll not get far this way, Private.
Back.
This is a lot of work.
Last time I saw ya. Okay, now here's the chicken. The prime objective.
Some chicken.
Get the chicken.
Huh?
You have to stand on your feet, Private, to get the chicken.
I'll get him this time. Don't worry about it.
Shall I ask for another
bye. Why did I go and volunteer? What a stupid life. Here I am crawling out in the middle of some dumb cornfield and Colonel Sanders is back there in his nice cozy tent. I asked him what to use for a weapon. He says, pick up a corn stalk. They don't shoot chickens, do they? Geez, they could at least cut a fence for me. Probably get stuck going over it. I'll tell you, this is mighty hard on the clothes. Let alone the skin. All for a stupid chicken. Who wants a chicken anyway? Must have some importance to the colonel. Maybe it's a moral war. Probably just to prove something to the enemy. Anyway, I'll get this sentry. Hope he don't hate me for it. It's kind of stupid looking, though. I guess he deserves everything he gets. Goodbye, old comrade. Get his watch now. Wentworth's got some money on him. Maybe he's a rich beggar. Hey, this Timex is still running. Looks like that's about it. Whoops, my club. Off again. Now through all this manure, they could at least clean up the barnyard. Horses, plenty of horses. We could steal them instead of a chicken. It must be 50 times the size. I'll have to catch one on my way out. Make it a lot faster. Another fence. They could at least get these fences out of the way. And a roof yet. Probably fall off and bust something. Steep one at that. This chicken better be mighty important, boy. I tell you, this is getting to be awful hard. Especially with a corn stalk. You could at least give me a gun or something. And it's windy out here. I'd be careful now. Getting close. There he is. I hope this darn hazel don't duck like the last one. Poor guy. Hope I don't get shot for switching uniforms if they catch me. Boy, this guy's stiff already. Look at him. Hope he's worth more than what the last one was. And his watch is still running, too. What is it with these guys? They're all pretty ritzy. Now for the chicken house. He's gonna make a good eating. So much for their supply hut. Oh man, I'm the new cook.
Hello, howdy.
Guess I know what I have for supper tonight.
Yep, chicken. It's all easy going now. One last fence. All these fences, geez, you think they could cut the fences for me?
What's this?
Hey, what happened to
the hell? They stole the chicken.
Hey,
they got our chicken.
Look, there's the tracks.
He went that way. Let's follow him.
We
got to
get that chicken back.
Yeah. Let's get our chicken.
Where'd he go? Where'd he go?
Down there. Went down there. We're gonna get our army, boy. You're gonna be sorry. We'll get our army and get her back.
That general must be crazy.
What are you doing going down the hill here?
Where are we anyway?
Well, I can't swim.
Where are the jungles of Asia? Where are we?
We're gonna get that chicken back.
Hey, don't go that way, man. It's poison ivy.
Hey, Jaskowski, did you put on your deodorant this morning?
Nah, Jim Linsky. I got 24 hour protection. I'm safe.
That's right. Yeah, hey, I'm
going to
poison ivy.
Keep going up the hill.
Is that what that rash is?
Keep your heads down.
Keep down low.
Get up here.
Hey, this reminds me of maneuvers of college.
Get John. He's back there caught in the bushes.
At the beach.
Colonel, 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 Colonel